In this movie, you will learn how to combine Morphomatic and Morph Toolkit to create very efficient facial rigging controllers. We will be using a technique described by Jason Osipa in his book entitled Stop Staring, Facial Animation Done Right. A really good book that we strongly recommend you read. This type of rig is being used more and more in production studios worldwide, so I will show you how to set this up very quickly using Morphomatic and wire parameters. Here we have a head, courtesy of our friends at Blur Studio, set up using Morphomatic modifier to control its numerous morph targets, which include progressive morphs for the jaw opening and for the jaw's left to right movement as well. We will be using simple shapes as control objects, but you could use any shape matching the style of your character rig. A simple rectangle will do for us today. Inside of the rectangle, we will add a circle. Then we can adjust the size of the rectangle and circle to a more workable size, and we will link the circle to the rectangle. Next, we will connect the X value of the circle to the left and right motion of the jaw, and the Y value to the jaw opening of our character. To do so, we will use 3ds Max wire parameters. So with the circle selected, we right-click and choose Wire Parameters, then pick Transform, then Position, and then we can select the X position. Once this is done, click on the head, and then select Modified Object, Morphomatic, and we wish to use the mouse side channel, and let's pick the progressive track. First, we set the parameter wiring to be bidirectional, and then we use a divide by 100 and multiply by 100 connection, because the two values we wish to connect are not using the same scale. One being from 0 to 1, and the other from 0 to 100. Once this is done, let's hit connect. Whenever we move the circle from left to right, we can see the jaw very effectively going from left to right. Now let's repeat the same wiring operation for the jaw opening. Still with the circle object selected, let's right-click and select Wire Parameters, then Transform, and in its position, we select the Y position. Let's then click on the head, select Modified Object, Morphomatic, then Mouth Opening, and again here do we have the progressive track. Let's make it a bidirectional wire parameter, and as we have done previously, we are going to use a divide by 100 and multiply by 100 to ensure that all values are using the same scale. And then we hit connect. If we do move the circle now, we can see the full effect of the jawbone rotation in action. As you can see, we actually need to invert the values, as when the circle object goes up, the jaw opens, and when it goes down, it is closing, but it should be the opposite. To fix this, we are going to invert the values. So let's right-click on the time slider, select Controller Properties, and select the Y position. And here, we are simply going to multiply the value by minus 100 instead of 100. So now, whenever the circle goes up or down, the jaw will open accordingly. And if we move that object freely, we can reach specific poses very nicely and efficiently by controlling multiple morph channels at once. This method makes it very cool to animate morph targets, as we do not have to worry about manually changing values. We now have full interactive control over the jaw rotation of our character using the circle as a control object. Next, we want to adjust the lower teeth, as we do want them to follow nicely when the jaw rotates. For this, we are going to use a feature from Morph Toolkit, another plugin from Di-O-Matic. We will start by selecting the lower teeth and then go in the Motion panel and apply a Link-O-Matic controller to the Teeth Transform controller. Within the Link-O-Matic controller options, we could choose to link the teeth to selected vertices from the head. First, we pick the head object. We are simply selecting 3 points under the lower lips, like this. And then for the rotation points, we are going to pick 2 points, which will serve as pivot points for the rotation of the lower teeth. Just by doing this quick setup in Link-O-Matic, if we do now move the control object, we can see that the teeth are perfectly following the jaw motion, and we didn't need to actually include the teeth in our morph targets or script anything. We simply used Link-O-Matic, and the teeth will, from now on, always follow whenever we animate the jaw using this OSIPA style control we quickly created. So as you can see, it is very quick to actually create a facial rig using custom controls like this. Here we used Morph-O-Matic and Morph Toolkit, as well as the wire parameters tools from 3ds Max. Thank you for watching this video tutorial on how to create OSIPA style controls for your facial rigs. If you are not already using Morph-O-Matic, don't hesitate to download the trial version and to check out other Di-O-Matic products like Morph Toolkit on our website at www.diomatic.com.